Hello friends, welcome to Civil Twin. Today we are going to see design of staircase. So here we are having the data for designing a staircase. So type of staircase is dog-legged staircase with waist slab, treads and riser. Tread T is equal to 270 mm, rise equal to 150 mm, span is equal to 4050 mm. We are using M20 grade of concrete and Fe 500 bars. Initial step in the design of staircase is to find the effective span. So number of steps in one flight is taken as 10. Then number of threads is equal to this number of steps in one flight minus 1 will give you number of threads. So it is 9. Then the space occupied by a threads, which is equal to 9 into dimension of thread, that is 270 mm. So it is given as 0.27, which is equal to 2.43 meter. Then effective span is equal to this 2.43 meter plus 2 into 1.8. This is the dimension of waist slab plus 0.23. This is the thickness of the wall. So effective span is equal to 6.26 meter. Next step is to calculate the thickness of waist slab. So the thickness of waist slab is equal to span divided by 20. So we know that span is equal to 4050 mm divided by 20 will give you answer as 200 mm. Then we are assuming the effective cover D dash is equal to 20 mm. Therefore effective depth of the waist slab D is equal to thickness of waist slab minus effective cover, that is 200 minus 20, which is equal to 180 mm. Next is load calculation. So we are calculating self weight of the slab on slope WS, which is equal to 0.2 into 1 into 25. This 0.2 is the thickness of the waist slab and this is the span. We will be taking it as 1 meter for design purpose into 25, which is equal to 5 kilonewton per meter. So this is the span of the waist slab. Next is self weight of the slab on horizontal. So we have the formula for this: WS into root of R square, that is riser, plus T square, that is thread, divided by T. So WS is 5 kilonewton per meter into root of 0.15 square plus 0.27 square divided by 0.27, which will give you the answer as 5.71 kilonewton per meter, that is the self weight of slab on horizontal. So the next load we are going to calculate is self weight of one step. So it is 0.5, that is half into BH. So it is 0.5 into 0.27 into 0.15 into unit weight of concrete. So it gives the answer as 0.5 kilonewton per meter. Next is self weight of step for 1 meter length. So we know the self weight of one step. So into 1 meter divided by the thread, which will give you the self weight of step for 1 meter length, that is 1.85 kilonewton per meter. So we will be taking the floor finish as 1 kilonewton per meter always. So the total load is equal to, by adding all these loads, we will be getting the total dead load, that is 8.56 kilonewton per meter. Then live load is equal to 10 kilonewton per meter. This value is taken from IS 875-1987 part 2. Therefore, total load is equal to 8.56 kilonewton per meter plus 10 kilonewton per meter, which is equal to 18.56 kilonewton per meter. So factored load WU is equal to 1.5 into total load, that is 1.5 into 18.56, which is equal to 27.84 kilonewton per meter. Bending moment and shear force. Maximum bending moment is equal to WL square divided by 8. The loads are taken as uniformly distributed load. So we are using WL square divided by 8. So it is 27.8 into 6.26 square divided by 8, which is equal to 136.37 kilonewton meter. Next is shear force. Shear force is equal to WL by 2. So W is 27.8, L is equal to 6.26 divided by 2. So the shear force is 87.01 kilonewton. Next step is to check for effective depth. By rearranging this formula, we will be getting answer as 220 mm, which is greater than 100 mm, so safe for providing the effective depth. So we are calculating the main reinforcement. Mu is equal to 0.87 FYASTD into 1 minus FYASD divided by FCKBD. We know that Mu is equal to 136.37 into 10 power 6, which is equal to 0.87. FY is equal to 500. D is equal to 220 mm into 1 minus 500 ASD divided by FCK is 20. B is taken as 1 meter, that is 1000 mm, and D is equal to 250 mm. So by substituting all these values, we will be getting the ASD as 1696.40 mm square. So now we are using 16 mm dia bars. So the spacing is equal to area of single rod divided by total ASD into 1000, that is pi by 4. 1 by 4 is denoted as 0.25 into 16 square divided by the total ASD we have found, that is 1696.40, which will give you the spacing as 120 mm. So provide 16 mm dia bars at 120 mm center to center spacing as the main reinforcement. Next is distribution reinforcement. So ASD minimum is provided as distribution reinforcement. So ASD minimum is equal to 0.12% of cross-sectional area. So 0.12 divided by 100 into 220, that is D into B, that is 1 meter, which is taken as 1000 mm. So ASD minimum is equal to 528 mm square. So we are using 8 mm dia bars for distribution reinforcement. We are finding spacing in the similar way we have calculated for main reinforcement, that is area of single rod divided by the total ASD into 1000. So it is pi by 4 into 8 square divided by 528, which is equal to 100 mm. So provide 8 mm dia bars at 100 mm center to center spacing as the distribution reinforcement. Calculation of shear stress. So we are going to calculate tau V and tau C, and we are going to compare. So tau V is equal to VU divided by B into D. We know the value of shear stress, which we have calculated earlier as 87.01 into 10 power 3 divided by B is taken as 1000 mm and D is taken as 220 mm. So tau V is equal to 0.39 Newton per mm square. So next, for calculating tau C, percentage ASD is calculated, which is equal to 100 into ASD divided by B into D. So 100 into ASD value, that is 1696.40 divided by 1000 mm into 220 mm. So we get the answer as 0.77%. So K into tau C, K is taken as 1.15. So it is 0.77 into 1.15, that is equal to 0.88 Newton per mm square. So K into tau C is greater than tau V, hence provide minimum reinforcement for the shear reinforcement. So this is the reinforcement detailing of the staircase which we have designed now. So here we are provided main reinforcement as 16 mm dia bars at 120 mm spacing. So this is the main reinforcement, and this is the distribution reinforcement, which is provided as 8 mm dia bars at 100 mm center to center spacing. Thank you for watching our video. For more videos, subscribe to our channel. Give us your feedbacks and suggestions for our further improvements. Thank you.